Today I'm going to show you why these two colors are the most important colors inside of Blender and why you cannot master these nodes without understanding these two colors. This is the tutorial I wish I had when I was starting out, because I am going to explain how things work visually. So let the tutorial begin. Let's start with the absolute basics. Understanding what these two colors and what it stands for is going to be very important. I have a black and white color right now, but actually this is not really black and white, but 0 and 1. 0 denotes black and 1 denotes white. Think of the color as a visual representation and the value as a numerical representation. I am going to use this pattern instead of black, since that is easier for me. So that is our black and white along with its numerical representation. Now let's take a hypothetical mix node. It has a value which can either be 0 or 1, and two values where it can be two colors. If the value is 0, the first color is outputted. And if the value is 1, the second color is outputted. You can also think of the mix node as 0 and 1, instead of 01 and 02, if that is easier to understand. What will happen if this is your value? It is half black and half white. And these are our black and white values. It will be half your first color and half your second color. Last one. What will be your output if this is your value? It will look like this. I hope you understood what black and white values do and the concept of 0 and 1. Now I have to tell you that I have been lying to you all this time. Because there are infinite numbers between 0 and 1. Since any decimal value between 0 and 1 can come between them, like 0.5 or 0.75 and 0.25. So instead of thinking of it as 0 and 1, think of it as percentages from 0% to 100%. What will happen if we use 0.5 in the value of our mix node? It would have mixed 50% of the first color and 50% of the second color and outputted that color. Similarly with 75% and 25%. The colors will also change as well, with it going from brighter to darker shades of gray. Now let's go into Blender and see the full potential of this method. Okay, now we are back in Blender. Let's start off by adding a mesh cube. Let's rotate it a little bit. Let me add a new material. And before I do anything, I just want to go over the mix node in here, set this to color, and show you the same thing I did visually inside of Blender. Going to set this to red, this to blue. Let's set this to 0. Let's preview it. And as you can see, when it is 0, it is red. When it is 1, it is cyan. That is working exactly like the way we thought it would work. And if I am going to increase the fact value, right now if I am setting it to 0.5, it is taking 50% of the red and 50% of the cyan and mixing them together. And if I am going to take an RGB node, set this to white by increasing this, set it to factor. Right now it is giving us the cyan because white is equal to 1 and this is our 1 slot. A would be our 0 slot and B would be our 1 slot. And when it is black, it's outputting red. In the end, I also told you about the percentage concept, right? So it's better to think of this bar as a percentage. It's starting from 0% to 100%. So 50% would be somewhere around here. 25% would be around here. And 75% would be somewhere around here. So think of this bar as a percentage bar from 0 to 100. But now the question is, how is this going to help me? Like, you don't want to sit there and mix nodes, basically. Oh, one more thing. Right now it is set to mix, right? But mix is not the only blending option we have. There is multiple different blending options in here. So let's go back. I didn't tell you all this to simply mix different colors together. There is a bigger purpose to this. So right now, if I'm taking this, Shift D to copy it. Let me make this yellow and this blue. If I mix them together, Ctrl Shift, right mouse button and drag, you get a mix shader. And again, it also has the fact value. It is also doing the same thing as I had shown earlier. If I take an RGB in here, set this to white, it's outputting blue. And when it's black, it's outputting yellow. Okay, that's all great. But if I'm going to use a noise texture in here, let's preview it. That is how it looks. If I'm going to add a color ramp and crush the dark and bright values, what will happen now? If I'm going to preview this mix shader, what will be the output? Just a quick break to tell you that this tutorial is part of course I have made for Blender procedural textures. And if you are someone who have struggled to understand procedural textures and creating amazing textures inside of Blender, this course is for you. In this course, I am going to share all the knowledge I have learned after doing 2 years of everydays inside of Blender. And the biggest advantage with using a procedural texture is that it is highly, highly editable and you can have complete control over it. So if this is something that interests you, do check out the course, link in the description. Let's continue with the tutorial. If you remember this example which I showed you visually, this should be the result. And I hope you understand why this is happening right now. Why when we use black and white, we are getting this mask. It is because it is linked to 0 and 1. Okay, that is one possibility with this. But if you look closely to the principal BSDF, you can see that 90% of the inputs uses 0 and 1 value. Like right here, this subsurface is a 0-1 value, metallic is a 0-1 value, specular is a 0-1 value. Similarly, roughness, anisotropic, transmission roughness, alpha, all these are 0 to 1 values. So we can use the same technique to manipulate all these values. For example, if I am going to plug this color into alpha, before that let me show you what alpha does. When alpha is 0, it disappears, and when alpha is 1, it is visible. So if I plug this into our alpha, guess what will happen? It will look like this. And if I am going to use this into roughness, let me preview how roughness at 0 looks and how roughness at 1 looks. And if I am going to put this into roughness, let me increase this a little bit. Right now you can see in the edges, there is a lot of roughness detail in it. So why is that happening? Again, it is because of the black and white color we are using and how it is linked to 0 and 1. So you can see the roughness only goes from 0 to 1. And the same thing can be used for transmission as well. This can be used for subsurface as well. And inside the texture course, I am going to go all in on showing you how to use this black and white values to create amazing textures. Right now you see there's a lot of blending options, right? So I'm going to like go in depth in how to use different blending options as well. And so primarily that is the main use of using the 0 and 1 values. We can use it as a fact in the mix shader. We can use that as factor in the mix node. We can use that to manipulate all these different things in the principal BSDF. So whenever you see 0 and 1 values, you can use this technique in there and create amazing textures. So I hope you understood the basics of the 0 and 1 values and how it is linked to black and white. Let me show you one more example. If I'm going to take a gradient texture, let's preview it. Okay, that's how it's looking. Select this, Control T. Set this to object. If I'm going to plug this into our roughness, set this to easing and preview it. It's not visible. I'm going to mix these two together and use this to the effect. Okay, right now you can see what the gradient is doing. So basically what is happening is where there is black, we are getting the yellow texture. And since there is a nice blend between the black and white values, we are getting a very cool falloff. That is what is happening. So guess what will happen if I'm going to set this into our transmission and preview it. Yeah, so what is happening right now? So basically, this side is becoming transmissive and this side is not becoming transmissive, and there's a very smooth falloff between them. So I hope you got a very solid idea on how 0 and 1 works inside of Blender and how the black and white color are linked to the 0 and 1 value. And inside the course, I'm going to go crazy in depth about this technique and how you can leverage these nodes and the basic understanding of 0 and 1 to create amazing textures inside of Blender. Thanks for watching.